Thank you for joining me today. This is Rivkah with Treasures of Glory. This is Prayer Team episode number 11. This episode is titled Covenant of Peace. We are in a series of excerpts from my book, Covenant and Religion, from the series Keeping Covenant with the Lord in the Seven Mountains of Culture. This book can be purchased at treasuresofglory.com, Amazon, or wherever books are sold. In addition, I'm offering a limited time offer for the Kindle version for 99 cents at Amazon. Links are in the description box below. I'll be covering excerpts from some of the chapters of this book over the course of the next couple of weeks. However, in these videos, I'll only be covering a portion of the chapters and won't be including all of the biblical principles for the healing of a nation that are covered in the book. So if you like what you hear in these videos and want to go deeper, you'll want to have this book as a resource for your library. Please click the subscribe button and the bell for notifications for future videos. If you like the information in this video, please click the like button. Clicking like helps the algorithms to promote it so more people can view it. Please share this video to those who are interested in praying for our nation. If you would like to receive emails about our prayer team, the sign-up link is in the description box below. And here's the verse that our prayer team is based on. It is written in 2 Chronicles 7:14, "If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray, and seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven, and will forgive their sin, and will heal their land." Let me open us up in a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you in the mighty name of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ. We praise you and give you glory. I speak the blood of Yeshua Jesus over our households, bank accounts, businesses, ministries, and everything under our stewardship in the name of Yeshua Jesus. We plead the blood of Yeshua Jesus over President Trump, his family, and all those who are appointed to govern alongside him. We pray and put on the full armor of God, which is the belt of truth, breastplate of righteousness, feet fitted with the preparation of the gospel of peace, the shield of faith that extinguishes the flaming darts of the wicked one, taking up the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, taking up the garments of vengeance and the cloak of zeal, having the Lord as our shield and the glory of the Lord as our rear guard. We pray that every curse, hex, vex, spell, incantation, form of witchcraft, voodoo, dark art, or other form of weaponized demonic activity are reversed and sent against the heads of the sender sevenfold, that they would know that Yeshua, Jesus, is Lord. We declare that every human spirit, hybrid spirit, demonic spirit, synthetic spirit, or a spirit child on assignment to create distraction, confusion, or the triggering of bombs, booby traps, tripwires, or other types of programming are now discovered and bound in chains and fetters of iron and put wherever the true Yeshua HaMashiach, Lord Jesus, sent them. We thank you that there is martial law instituted on all parts of the humanity of those listening, attempting to go out of body and engage in astral traffic and trade that is ungodly and unauthorized. We thank you, Holy Spirit of truth, to guide us into all truth. We call this time blessed and fruitful in the mighty name of Yeshua, Jesus. Amen. This is the covenant of peace. It is written in Malachi 2, verses 4 through 5, "Then you shall know that I have sent this commandment to you, that my covenant with Levi may continue, says the Lord of hosts. My covenant was with him, one of life and peace, and I gave them to him that he might fear me. So he feared me and was reverent before my name. The law of truth was in his mouth, and injustice was not found on his lips. He walked with me in peace and equity and turned many from iniquity." The Lord of hosts holds the covenant of peace and shalom in high regard. Several instances in the Old Testament reveal the Lord making a covenant of peace with individuals, the nation of Israel, and with priests. In the case of the priests, the Lord of hosts made a covenant of life and peace with Levi and his descendants. The covenant of peace, shalom, is better understood by taking a look at the definition of shalom from Strong's H7965, which means completeness in number, safety and soundness in body, welfare, health, prosperity, peace with God, especially in covenant relationship. Shalom comes from a root word from Strong's H7999 that means covenant of peace. Let us join together in repenting of how we, as the members of the royal priesthood, have not kept the covenant of peace with the Lord of hosts by our actions, those in our generations and our nation, in order that we may replace this with living from the covenant of peace and extending its provision to those entrusted to us by the Lord. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you in the mighty name of Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christ, and as a member of the royal priesthood, I repent on behalf of myself, my generations, and my nation for not extending the covenant of peace that you made with me to others. And I repent on behalf of us of being exclusive of extending the grace, mercy, and provision of the covenant of peace. I repent of not looking out for the safety of others. I repent of not taking care of the welfare and health of others. I repent of not looking out for the best interest of another person prospering. And I repent of not being a good representative and steward of the covenant of peace in order to bless others. And I choose to replace and loose in my life, in my generations, in the nation, choosing to live from the covenant of peace and shalom, looking out for the safety of others, taking care of the welfare and health of others, and looking out for the best interest of another person prospering, and being a good representative and steward of the covenant of peace in order to bring blessings to others. I ask to repent on behalf of myself, my generations, and my nation for not being one to proclaim good news and proclaiming the good news of peace, for not walking in peace and being a living example of what it means to walk in peace and equity with the Lord. I repent for proclaiming bad news instead of the good news of peace to others and spreading its negative effects. And I replace and I loose in my life and generations in the nation, living from the covenant of peace, having feet that bring good news, proclaiming peace, bringing glad news of good things, proclaiming salvation, and saying to Zion, your God reigns. I repent on behalf of myself, my generations, and my nation for the ways of not keeping covenant of the peace with the Lord, by not walking in equity with the Lord and how it has affected other people through my actions. I repent for committing works of unrighteousness that have caused pain to others or have caused others to stumble in their lives, and for not turning others away from iniquity and how it has negatively affected their lives. I choose to replace in my life and loose in my life, in my generations, and in the nation, walking in equity and uprightness, walking uprightly, working righteousness, and speaking the truth in our hearts, rescuing others from iniquity. It is written in Ezekiel 33:6, but if the watchman sees the sword come, and blow not the trumpet, and the people not be warned, if the sword come and take any person from among them, he is taken away in his iniquity, but his blood I will require at the watchman's hand. So, Father, I pray that you would loose that watchman's eye, that look of watchman, of protecting people, of sounding the alarm in our nation. And also, I replace and loose in my life, generations, and in our nation, being able, saving others by snatching them from the fire. Dear Heavenly Father, I choose to forgive from my heart, myself, my generations, and any person that comes to mind in our nation for how he or she did not keep the covenant of the Lord by these things that I'm going to list, which caused injury to myself or other loved ones, either now or in the past. I forgive them for being exclusive of extending the grace, mercy, and provision of the covenant of peace. I forgive them for not looking out for the safety of others. I forgive them for not taking care of the welfare and health of others. I forgive them for not looking out for the best interest of another person prospering. I forgive them for not being a good representative and steward of the covenant of peace in order to bless others. I forgive them for not being one to proclaim good news and not proclaiming the good news of peace. I forgive them for not walking in peace and being a living example of what it means to walk in peace and equity with the Lord. I forgive them for proclaiming bad news instead of the good news of peace to others and spreading its negative effects. I forgive them for not walking in equity with the Lord. I forgive them for committing works of unrighteousness that cause pain or causing others to stumble, and forgive them for not turning others away from iniquity. Dear Heavenly Father, we pray these things over our nation, and we ask that your blessing would be upon us as we return to you and as we repent, and we ask for a change in our nation, returning back to living from the covenant of peace. And we ask these things in your Son's name, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Yeshua. Amen. I'm going to say a blessing over you in just one moment. In the meantime, it's important to keep balanced in the midst of talking about these deep topics with spiritual warfare. We need to make sure that we are ministering to and caring for our spirit, soul, and body. It is written in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 23 through 24. Now may the God of peace himself sanctify you completely, and may your whole spirit, soul, and body be preserved blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. He who calls you is faithful, who will also do it. I offer resources on Treasures of Glory for ministering to the human spirit, soul, and body. I have blessings for ministering to the spirit. I have the Fruit of the Holy Spirit, a spiritual warfare series, blessings for love, joy, peace on spirit-to-spirit blessings, and also the blessings for exceeding joy blessings, part one. In addition, I offer ministry to the soul. I have the Fruit of the Holy Spirit, a spiritual warfare series, and I also have these two books from the series of Keeping Covenant with the Lord and the Seven Mountains of Culture on covenant and religion and covenant and family. As far as ministering to the body, I offer Treasured Wellness 365 consultations. This works at the quantum level of the body for it to be able to, on its own, heal itself to release various toxins and pathogens. I have links to these in the description box below. Thank you for supporting the prayer team through prayer and through financial contributions. If you're interested in contributing to this prayer team, the giving link is in the description box below. And now for the blessing. Beloved, as a son or daughter of the Most High God, you are part of the royal priesthood. He called you out of darkness and brought you into his marvelous light in order to expand his kingdom here on earth. Your heavenly Father pours out his mercy upon you, and his desire is that you will extend mercy to others. This covenant of peace is also called the covenant of shalom. The Hebrew word shalom means completeness in number, soundness in body, safety, welfare, health, prosperity, peace with God, especially in covenant relationship. This covenant of life and peace is given to you for you to steward and to extend the blessings of it to others. I bless you to live from the covenant of peace by looking out for and taking care of the safety and well-being of others. I bless you to be aware of the best interest of others and helping them to prosper as it is pleasing to the Lord. I bless you to be a good representative of the Lord of hosts in how you live from and steward the covenant of peace in order to bless others. May you speak the good news of the covenant of peace and bring glad tidings of good things to others. I bless you to proclaim salvation and the good news of the covenant of peace. Beloved, I bless you as a member of the royal priesthood to extend to others and to steward well the provision and protection promised in the covenant of life and peace. I bless you to walk with the Lord in peace and equity with him so that others may benefit from your uprightness. May you have wisdom, strength, and courage to turn many from iniquity. I bless you in the name of Yeshua, in the name of Jesus. Please join me next time for episode 12, Justice in the Covenant. Please click here for links to view other prayer team videos. The prayer team playlist includes Satanic Ritual Abuse, Why You Need to Know About It, Portland's Recipe for Anarchy, and also there's a playlist here for the Treasured Wellness 365 consultations that introduces them and the video on my testimonial of how this work has helped me. Thank you for joining me today. Shalom. God bless.